What up? This is Chris Cap. You're watching EC Sports.
Yeah, yo, check it. Turn me up a little bit on the mic.
EC Sports. We're at episode Marshall Falk, I believe.
28.
Number 28. Just before we get started, this is Ann, by the way. I want to let you guys know, I was going to wear that hat today. You see that? Yeah. Nick Foles, bro?
We'll get into that. I think we're going to disagree immensely on
hey,
this.
Hey, that's
spot.
Fine. We could disagree.
And I'll give a couple reasons why I feel the reasons that I may provide might change your mind a bit.
Yeah, I'm going bald with this show. That was terrible. You got an MVP Super Bowl freaking quarterback ready to go, a winner, and you get, I'm sorry, he won the Super Bowl.
But then he won MVP.
Yeah, and then he got his spot taken by Guy Manfred, whatever, what's the guy's name? Manchu Mania?
Garner. We'll get into that. I'm going to talk a little bit about that. I think I can say some things on the show that may change your mind. I think you're going to have to face reality by the end of the show.
I mean, the reality is already faced. I mean, he's here. It's not like,
I think there's a far more of reality into this whole topic.
Cam will be here for real.
Forget about him. So let's go over some free agent acquisitions, and then we'll get into it. We'll get into it. First, we got the Colts picking up Philly Rivers on a one-year, $25 million deal. How do you feel about that?
How much is guaranteed?
$25 million.
He's getting 25.
1 year, 25,
just
guaranteed 25. That. Boom. Sign the dotted line.
Here's
25 in your checking account. Done.
Dude, wow. I don't know about that money. But for a guy that's what? Has he won anything?
No.
Yeah. Bad move. In reference to money. Sorry for the ashy hands, but it was a lotion on.
It's that COVID crap they call it.
Necessary. But, yeah, I don't know about that move, bro. That was a tough one.
Okay.
Tough move.
All right.
For $25 million, that's a lot of money.
Okay. Next
one. A lot of money, buddy.
I feel it's a lot of money. I think Philly could actually strive in that Indianapolis offense.
Okay.
Much like the San Diego offense.
Oh.
However, they're going to have to run the ball quite a bit. And I'd like to see them try, since we haven't seen Indy run the past, 20 years. Since I've been alive. They haven't ran since the edge. Edwin James.
Wow. Hey, they have a 1,000-yard rusher, okay? He got me almost to the playoff. Yeah. I'm not going to talk about that.
Let's get into the Carolina Panthers. Carolina picks up Teddy Bridge.
You're promoting a lot of that guy on your end.
I would have actually loved to see the Bears get Teddy Bridge.
He got too much money, too.
The problem is that the Bears actually offered Teddy a three-year, $60 million deal.
Which is what
$20 million a year.
Oh.
Signed for the exact same price out in Carolina. So there you
Comfort.
Have it. The camp of Teddy reportedly said, Teddy goes to Carolina, he has no comp. Teddy goes to Chicago, he's in a quarterback battle with Mitchell True.
With Mitchie Trubisky.
So how do you feel about that?
Good for Carolina. I mean, they're cleaning house. Got rid of Rivera first.
Mm-hmm.
When you got a new owner and a new coach.
Yeah.
Just like the Bulls are going to see next year. You're going to change with the grain, bro. They went to the Super Bowl.
Went to the Super Bowl.
With a really good quarterback. That I would love to be in Chicago. That's not. They did everything they could do with the guys in place. So they got rid of Greg, Cam. They got a nice little running back who you had on your team.
Beautiful running back. The best in the league.
Rode him to the wheels fell off in the playoffs.
Best in the league.
Boom. Your wheels did fall off.
Best in the league. Receiving, running, best in the league.
We'll see what the offense does this year.
I'm pretty excited about it. I think Teddy's a franchise player, bro.
He's going to be key. What?
I think Teddy's a franchise player.
He has one leg, bro.
think he's a franchise player.
He has one.
I think his ability to come in under a very lucrative offense. Yeah, he does.
That's the good thing for him. He knows the offense.
He does. That's a big leg up.
Not hating. Good for you, Teddy.
Good for Teddy.
So the Bears offered him, and he didn't come because he didn't want any competition. Got it. He wanted to play. Makes sense.
Correct. Now that Teddy has departed, now Malcolm Jenkins is actually returning to the Saints. This was a total Sean Payton deal. Sean Payton was dying to get Malcolm Jenkins back in the mix after he left. Sean said that while he left, the leaving presser at the time was devastating to him, and that he had wanted Malcolm back the second he had walked out of the door. Malcolm is known to be a good leader, vocal leader, good guy around the NFL. I think it's a good move for the Saints. The Saints have tried desperately to make a Super Bowl run as they fell short, you know, for the past 3 years.
A lot of shortfalls.
You think that's going to be good, or what do you think about this?
A lot of shortfalls.
A lot of shortfalls.
I had Michael Thomas last year, and I equate a lot of stuff to my fantasy team, which is what I should do. And he didn't do shit.
Which is what I should do.
He didn't do a damn thing.
You talking about Michael?
Yeah.
He had traded him. He had a great season.
I traded him.
He had a great season.
He had a great season, not for me.
He had a great season.
I guess having Le'Veon Bell 2 years in a row hurts you too. But no.
That'll help. That'll hurt.
The Saints are always in it. When you got Drew Brees at the helm, Sean Payton, they always have a chance. Okay. It's just all about the competition. So, with that being said, it's all about when does the new CBA go through? Is that 21-22 or 2021?
2021.
So, this season? No.
I believe so.
The 17 game? No, that's next year.
Are you sure?
I think it said 21.
You might be right.
I don't think they're going to.
I don't know. I really can't.
Especially now.
Yeah. I cannot wait for the NBA-type playoff format, though. Seven teams out of each side, best seed, first two get a bye. Mm-hmm. It's much like the league.
Mm-hmm. That's how it should go. And
excited about it.
I think they'll be in the same situation that they were.
And
they'll probably win
11,
12 games, get to the playoffs, and then meet somebody that's on a streak, and then we'll see what happens.
Very bold prediction. Considering the division is going to be tight this year.
Why?
Which transitions into my next theory. The transition's going to be tight. The transition of this division is going to be tight. Number one, Teddy Bridge down in Carolina, going to add some fuel there. Obviously, definitely weapons on offense. But then, which leads us into our next topic of discussion, $30 million a year, TB12 enters the division, ladies and gentlemen, with a high-powered offense. TB12 in the Bucks. TB12 now enters the NFC South. The NFC South is going to be booming.
Yeah.
Because we got...
What?
We got,
say that again?
Business is going to be booming down there in the
you
NFC.
You say booming?
South. Booming.
Sounds familiar.
Sounds very familiar.
You know who that is?
Who's that?
I don't know. You talk about him. You love him so much.
We'll get into that.
Okay.
So, Buccaneers now have Tom Brady. Tom Brady now has Godwin.
Ooh.
Evans.
Ouch.
O.J. Howard. Rashad Perriman. And Ronald Jones at receiver, who, by the way, is very nice.
He's a running back.
Ronald Jones at running back, I'm sorry. Who's very nice in the pass game. Typical Brady running back. So, with all that high power.
OJ's going to get a lot of passes.
OJ's going to get a lot of love. He's big, and he can move, and he's going to get a lot of love.
He just was used wrong.
Terribly.
I mean, quarterbacks throw in 30 interceptions.
I mean, tight ends don't typically fare well when J-Mo is throwing 40 yards down the field to pop. You know, 500 yards throwing every game, four picks, five touchdowns.
Yeah.
30 pick season.
Yeah.
I mean, the numbers, they speak for themselves. I'm balling. Did you hear him say that?
Yeah.
Did you hear him say that?
No, before or after you got the crab legs?
That was after. So, new regime down there. Bruce Arians taking over in his second season. Bucks are going to be competitive, I can promise you that.
You think?
Their defense is dirt. Their defense is, I love
bro,
their D.
My wife, and I got to tell everybody, when we were pulling the shoes out the box, she didn't understand what we were saying. She didn't get, like, you just said dirt. She's like, I thought he just said they were good. So we have to explain.
You know, dirt could go good or bad. Yes. Depending
when
on how I
say it. Hey, these shits are stupid, dumb, disgusting. EC Sports lingo, it's the shit.
Yeah, okay? It's the shit.
If we say, yeah, all right, go Mitchie, we're being sarcastic.
If I say Tom Brady and that offense is going to be dirt, that means they're going to be good. Mm-hmm. But if I say the Bears have Anthony Miller at receiver and Mitchell Trubisky at quarterback, they're going to be dirt. That means they're going to be shit.
See how we accentuate? He said dirt. I said doo-doo. Difference.
Correct.
Right? There we go.
Now let's talk about another team who made a playoff run last year for the first time in a while.
What's his name coming back? The guy with the really nice hairdo, broke his leg. And tight end, Bears.
Burton?
No.
Oh, you're talking about my guy. Yeah. Handsome.
Mm-hmm. He's very
Miller.
Handsome. Pause. But he's very handsome.
Oh.
Pause. See, I wouldn't do all that.
He's a good looking guy.
Bro, I wouldn't do the facial expression.
He's a good looking guy.
Okay.
He's done.
He's done. I think he's on the team.
He's a Mortadella sandwich.
He's got that tracked.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's done.
He's on the bench, travels.
Looks like he probably saved a few bucks though. I think he's gonna be all right. If all else fails, he could maybe, you know, go on a trial run over at Calvin Klein or maybe call in to CBS for a little panel job.
He's definitely going to take that.
Probably don't call CBS, though. Ooh, they already gave Romo $17 million a year.
That's what I remembered. You were like, oh, what are we going to do? I got this.
Okay, let's transition to another team that made a run last year. The Buffalo Bills have now acquired Stephon Diggs. Big, big time shit.
Bro, he's been wanting to leave for like...
that back.
He's been wanting to leave for how long?
His route running ability is unbelievable.
We keep talking about guys on my team. He almost got me to the playoffs.
He's a beast.
He's a beast. Do you think he wasn't getting enough balls? Balls?
I guess there was a little bit of animosity there between him and Uncle Kirk. Oh, by the way, shout out to Uncle Kirk. Another $66 million extension.
How do you like that?
He's at about $300 million in his career with about two playoff wins.
He's good. Good. Okay? Good.
He's got about two playoff wins.
Shit.
$300 million.
Hey.
It's Uncle Kirk.
See, if not,
how you like that?
If I'm looking at that, I'm thinking you guys are really happy for that guy. No. He's being facetious.
No, I like Kirk. I've been on Kirk's back for a while. I don't know if he's worth $300 million.
With how many? Two.
With a deucer. With a
deucey.
That's crazy.
One with the skinzos. The fuck? That's a lot of money, buddy.
The skinzos, they got cracked when he was on their playoff team.
They're trying to draft another quarterback, bro.
I don't. That would be so highly disrespectful.
Ronnie Riv wants his own.
Let's talk about another team. Speaking of doo-doo, that took a doo-doo over in the playoffs last year. The Baltimore Ravens just stacked up that already tenacious D-line.
Shit.
Acquired Calais Campbell.
Ouch.
For a bag of Vinnie Vinter salt and vinegar chips.
Oh!
And... obviously, they acquired Michael Brockers over from the Rams in L.A. This team is stacked. Their line now includes Calais Campbell, Michael Brockers, Brandon Williams, and Matthew Judon.
Wow.
So this line has just gotten better. Mm-hmm. The defensive backfield includes Humphrey, Smith, Peters, Humphrey, Smith, Peters. And Earl Thomas, ladies and gentlemen.
Earl, still in the building.
This team is, they are beyond stacked defensively. Offensively, their scheme is like any offensive scheme we've ever seen with the play of Lamar and out of the pistol formation. It's very tough to stop the running game of Mark Ingram. So I look for the Ravens.
I thought he was done until...
Who, Ingram?
Yeah.
Oh, he made a crazy surge.
Again, in fantasy, that motherfucker's busting my ass every time I play.
He made a crazy surge. Crazy surge. But
they needed him. They needed him.
When they needed him most.
But that's the thing. He never really got the chance with Kamara, who honestly fell back. He probably might go second or third round this year.
Who, Alvin?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, I think that was...
But... No, he will, because he didn't have, the fuck were we just talking about? Baltimore. Who's Baltimore? Who were you just talking about?
Mark Ingram?
There's no Ingram, and he still didn't really have a great season.
Right? I know.
Am I
right? Well, the thing is...
But they got Latavius Murray, too.
Correct.
So.
And he's very active in the pass game, which makes him in a PPR league. It makes him pretty dangerous.
Which isn't ours, but...
Which isn't ours.
Ours is very fun.
Yes.
I mean, you got in the playoffs.
I love it.
Yeah.
I always make a run, and then I shit the bed.
No.
Me? No, I might have to go TB12 this year. We'll see. We'll see how the cookie crumbles. Okay. But let's talk about two bums. Let's bring out two bums. They'll be playing backup next year. Let's go with
quarterbacks?
Let's go Cam Newton as our first bum. Word on the street is
Dion to the truck. This motherfucker did not just call Cam a bum, did he?
Cam.
Okay, I didn't think he did. Okay. We can edit that out. All
yeah,
right,
no.
Thanks. 10-4.
Don't edit it. It hasn't done much.
What the fuck are you talking about?
This man became a bum when he didn't dive on the football over in the Super Bowl. Number one.
First of all, that's how many years ago?
That was so bummish, it'll never be forgotten. I ever see a quarterback with the ball in front of him, biggest game of his entire career, running guy coming at him.
Mitchie T. He did it last year.
Yeah. If you want to, it's like who's the tallest midget or, you know, who's the top ant on a pile of shit. I mean, both of those two bums, both of them. Thank God they didn't come here. God forbid. First of all.
We would have went directly to the playoffs with Cam Newton.
Cam Newton.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And we need a fucking running back.
Just so you know.
Fuck
absolutely.
Montgomery.
And we need
fuck
a corner.
The midget.
We'll get into that. By the way, though, Cam Newton, ladies and gentlemen, he may have been the answer in Chicago, but he's never going to make a Super Bowl run. And guess what? With that being said, Cam Newton has no place to call home right about now. He'll be backup QB number 2. That's good, though. Just up that Under Armour contract. Pull out another pair of shoes that look like boots for me.
Go to Miami. Go to South Beach. Take over fucking Rosen. That's what they'll do.
Have fun with that. Good luck having him in Miami walking the strip at 6'5". Last thing he'll be thinking about is throwing the ball. Walking the strip at 6'5 in those goofy ass hats.
Whoa!
Let's go on to Winston bum number 2.
He's
again, reported this morning, and I quote, Winston looks like he'll have no place to call home as he'll be nothing but a number 2 quarterback. So, ladies and gentlemen, nowhere for this man to start. Coming off a 30 interception season.
No one's going to sign.
I said 3-0 interceptions.
Or they haven't gotten
no, they'll keep
well.
Staff. He's
no,
solid
he's
as can be.
Wifey said it. She put it on her Twitter. She said, I'd love to go to San Diego.
Wifey. I don't blame her.
San Diego.
Nothing like hanging out in D-Town.
San Diego, we got the TB12.
San Diego has named Tyrod Taylor the futuristic starter. Good luck, San Diego. San Diego did add some depth on their D-line, getting Jarrell Casey from the Titans.
So did the Bears.
Congratulations to them.
Are we going to talk? Because we have 8 minutes left.
Oh.
And I have to get through the why I threw my hat on.
We are going to transition right into a topic you've been waiting to get to. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bears have acquired, first of all, they have released Leonard Skinny Bones Floyd.
It was time.
Skinny Bones just got
seven
picked up by the Rams.
In 2 seasons, they picked him up. Good for them.
13 mil.
I mean,
too much money.
I think the Bears gave
that's
him a
one-year 13 mil.
They gave him a lot of chances, though.
They
he
gave
had
him
every opportunity.
You can't get more chances than that.
Why do you sign Trevathan, though? I mean, how many broken bones does it do?
29 years of age, Trevathan, playing inside backer.
Elbow intertwined.
I'm not too upset about the Trevathan signing. But let's get into Robert Quinn on that 5-year, $70 million contract. Bro, our defense, 29 years old, Robert Quinn.
Our defense is diarrhea doo-doo.
You don't like it?
No, I'm sorry. I shouldn't say doo-doo in our terms. Our defense is sick as a fucking snotty nose.
Oh, it's a runny nose in COVID-19 bro, season.
He said it. All I'm saying, our defense, bro, you're not bussing through that. You know how you wipe your ass, bust through? Not through our defense.
Not through this, D. This is that brick wall structure outside of the old soldier. Though. We need a cornerback like Helen Keller needed eyesight. Bro.
Are we going to draft?
We need a corner big.
We don't have a fucking...
There is no draft. There's no draft for the Bears this year, by the way.
Do we have a second?
I believe so.
Yeah, last year we did.
Yeah.
What are you drafting in the second round?
A corner if you don't get one now. A receiver. How about a receiver? Who are we throwing to? Allen Robinson? Beautiful receiver. 1,000-plus yards last year. That's it.
But that's all. And it just hits the fucking floor.
And then it's Miller time.
He's 5'2". Fucking, you can't keep throwing a Danny DeVito and think you're going to fucking get something.
He dropped 100 balls last season.
Gabriel's gone too.
Gabriel, see ya. But
so yeah, we need a fucking receiver.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk. Some people in the industry call him Nick Foles. Some people in our industry call him Big Dick Nick. Let's talk Nick talk. How do you feel about Nick?
I already said it, bro.
All right, perfect.
Which did you see the Soldier Boy interview? I'm bringing that up. When he said, Drake? Yeah. Nick Foles? Nick Foles?
It's going to segue me into the Nick Foles phenomenon. Ladies and gentlemen, I am so happy that we got Nick Foles. You have no idea. Why am I happy we got Nick Foles?
Why am I not leaving? You know, I would be respectful. I'll let you talk.
Okay. So, number 10 is the quarterback.
Yeah, 5 minutes.
Number 10 is the quarterback right now.
Who?
Number 10. I call him number 10 now. He's not even worthy of a name. I call him number 10. So number 10's the cue.
Yeah, look at him. As we talk, even our fans are telling me. Cam. Okay?
Number 10 is the cue. There you go,
guys. See it?
Listen, number 10's the cue, bottom line. The other bottom line is we've essentially got Nick Foles. Do you know what we got Nick Foles for?
And Michael Irvin, I'll switch it over to what I eat, a Sara Lee turkey sandwich.
Perfect.
Extra mayo.
A nice butterball roasted turkey breast.
With
fourth
Swiss.
Round pick, ladies and gentlemen. We got Nick Foles, Super Bowl champ, Super Bowl MVP.
Stop.
Cool, calm, and collected. Big Dick Nick coming in. For a fourth round pick. Do you know what that means to me?
That means Trey Burton gets his quarterback.
No. Let me just go like this. Let me sum it up for you. You know what that means?
What?
That means for a fourth round pick, we can watch anybody throw the ball next year but number 10. And for that, I am thankful. I am blessed. I am graced with the presence of number 9, Nicky Foles.
Seven.
Come on in.
7.
Oh, he's going to wear 7 this year? Come on in, Nikki. You know why? Because we got you for
so
nothing.
Can I ask you a question?
We got you for nothing, and you're going to do better than number 10 ever
saying,
did.
Are you saying that he's already got the spot? He's taking his spot?
It is without question. If he doesn't start week 1, he will start by week 3. You know as well as I do, number 10 will play himself so far out of the starting position. I don't know whether he'll throw a pick or whether he'll roll out backwards and instead of throwing the ball away, he'll run out of bounds for a loss of 5. I don't know what he's going to do. But what I do know is Nicky Foles is in the driver's seat in Chicago. Let me tell you something. When the Chicago Bear receiving core is begging for quarterbacks on Twitter.
Wait, who?
Cordero Patterson is out there recruiting. He said, I'm 0-3 on my recruiting process. Should I stop now?
So who did he want?
Anybody. He wanted Newton.
Bro,
he wanted Bridgewater.
How bogus is that, though? Like, I don't like Mitchie T, but what the fuck, bro?
To me, To me, that says Mitchie T's as good as dead. He's coming in with zero confidence. As if he had 10% confidence last year, he's got zero now.
How fucked up is that,
though? The Bears have slapped you in the face. Your receivers are campaigning for other quarterbacks to throw them the ball. The organization traded up to draft you, okay? Picked you with the number two pick in the NFL draft, and years later, they picked up a quarterback.
With that being said, it's going to be a new season. You got a seven. What is your take on the 17-game season that's coming up next season?
I love a 17.
And the new playoff format.
I love a 17-gamer. Beautiful 17-gamer.
Okay.
Absolutely adore it.
Less preseason.
Less preseason. What do we got? Two preseasons opposed to four?
Oh, so much better.
So much better.
Do you think that they're going to start on time this year?
Yes. I do.
What's the difference?
What do you mean?
Like, I guess I'm doing a COVID-19 segment with Anthony Healthcare D'Amato. What's the difference from, because they're pushing back OTAs as opposed to 2 months from now? Is there something that they're getting rid of? Is there a large animal that's affecting people, or are they just waiting for this vaccine?
I think it's precautionary action. Okay. I think that they understand that the OTAs are pretty much bullshit anyways.
They are.
They're, show up at your own, discretion.
Okay.
So we'll just push them back.
Have they announced the Hard Knocks team?
No, I don't believe so.
In Tampa.
I was disappointed with the Raiders last year.
It's actually disgusting.
May have been the worst one.
Not in a good way.
May have been the worst one.
It was dookie.
It was bad.
Dookie stains. Like, streaks.
It was bad.
Yeah.
I had to watch, you got to watch five episodes. You got to watch Derek Carr throw with his wedding ring on. I got news for you, pal. Maybe take that wedding ring off. It hasn't been doing too well for you out on the field.
Oh, speaking of that.
Maybe loosen up the old ring finger when you're throwing the rock around.
Speaking of that, since you're going to throw out the Raiders, I don't know if he's still a fan because they moved over to Las Vegas, but we're going to end our situation here. And now we're going to go over to Cali to Big Danny, who we got to – hey, thanks for helping the show last week because, the situation, we have to extend you.
Danny, fill us in on that DeAndre Hopkins marital status, baby mama's drama. Fill us in.
As well as him knocking
your West Coast.
But for Ant, it's Dion. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week. EC Sports.
What's going on, Dion? What's going on, Anthony? It's your host, Daniel Malgismal, for another edition of the EC Sports 2-Minute Drill. Let's get this thing going. It's the most talked about subject since the Houston Astros incident. Yes, I'm talking about the quarantine with COVID-19. Sean Payton actually tested positive as head coach of the New Orleans Saints yesterday with the virus. Sources of Adam Schefter saying he was feeling fine, but did get tested after mild symptoms. He is in good spirits, and we're hoping for a speedy recovery with him. Now, speaking of the NFL, non-virus related, a whole bunch of news and a whole bunch of shakeups are going on this NFL offseason. It's been crazy. Fireworks, signings, trades, the whole nine yards. You named it. We got it here at EC Sports 2-Minute Drill. Let's get this thing going for the offseason. Obviously, the biggest name to be moved this offseason is the GOAT, six-time Super Bowl champion Tom Brady. Yes, he has not returned to New England Patriots, and he's taking his talents not to South Beach, but to Tampa Bay. Yes, he will be signing a two-year, $50 million guaranteed deal with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Now, that move is going to be huge to revitalize the Bucs franchise after a subpar yet kind of interesting season from Jameis Winston after him throwing 33 touchdowns and 30 picks. The move is also interesting because you see a lot of greats in the end of their career going to different teams, such as Peyton Manning going to Denver Broncos, Joe Montana going from the Niners to the Chiefs, Brett Favre going from the Packers to the Jets and to the Vikings. So this is another step in the Hall of Fame quarterback's career. I think he's going to have a good season. I think Mike Evans, Rod Perriman, and of course Chris Godwin are going to have huge years. And don't be surprised if tight end O.J. Howard has a blossoming year as well. Brady loves his tight ends. And last but not least, how can we forget about my Las Vegas Raiders, right? The Raiders decided to roll the dice this offseason with a ton of cap space and a ton of draft capital. The Raiders made a move for Corey Littleton, one of the best linebackers in the NFL, formerly with the Los Angeles Rams. He signs a deal with the Raiders. They also added some depth with Nick Kwiatkowski, former Bear linebacker, Malik Collins, defensive tackle for the Dallas Cowboys, and some insurance program for Derek Carr as a backup with Marcus Mariota. Very interesting offseason for the Vegas Raiders. Let's see how they do in the draft. They got a ton of picks and a ton of money. Let's see how they spend it. And that just about wraps things up for the EC Sports 2-Minute Drill. Remember, guys, stay safe, stay quarantined, stay sanitized and disinfected, and prayers up to everybody who's recovering. We want a speedy, happy, healthy, and recovery.